Hi and welcome to another episode of my Small Business Entrepreneur video series. My name is John Edmonds. Today I want to discuss what business networking is all about and how you can participate in business networking to attract new clients and new customers. Business networking is frequently misunderstood. Many think that the whole idea of networking is to go along to a networking meeting and to attract new business from the other business people who attend the meeting. Although it's true that you may attract some people at these meetings to do business with you, as a general rule, you'll make more business from the friends and associates of the people at the meeting, the unseen third parties. Think about this for a moment. There's a thing called Dunbar's number, and that's the number of people that the average person can maintain a stable relationship with, either in business or in society. It's often quoted as 150 people, but others have proven that it's somewhere between 100 and 230. In other words, most people have up to 230 close friends and acquaintances. If you then add their virtual friends that they're connected to via LinkedIn and Twitter and Facebook and Academy and other similar social networks, then the figure escalates into thousands. What this means is that when you get to meet just one person at a networking meeting, you're actually talking to the key to the thousands of people in their network. Knowing this and understanding it is the secret to business networking. You see, it's not the person in front of you that counts, it's the people that they know. Go to a network meeting where there's 20 people and in effect you're looking at 20 keys to maybe 50,000 potential customers, each of which will also have their own network, possibly in thousands. It's a bit like the 6 degrees of separation principle, which says that everyone on the planet is only 6 people away from everyone else on the planet. Attending networking meetings is the real key to the locks of a much bigger network. To open up these locks means you need to build a good relationship with the people you meet, so much so that they start to recommend you to others that they know in their network. You see, the people at networking meetings don't want to listen to you trying to sell them your products or services. Explaining what your products are and what they do is okay. Just don't try to sell them at networking meetings. Others present will see right through you and unlikely to want to know you better. The truth is, no one likes being sold. If you think about it for a moment, when you attend a networking meeting, the very last thing you want is to hear someone trying to sell you his or her products and services. You didn't go there for that, and neither did the others at the networking meeting. I know many people who joined a networking group and left after a few weeks saying things like, "There's no point in going. It's the same people every week, and once you've tried them and sold them nothing, you can't really do it twice." And that's very common to hear people say that. What's happened, of course, is that they fell into the trap of thinking that the people at the networking meetings were their customers. They didn't widen their scope to see that each of the people at the networking meetings was in fact a key to a much bigger network outside the meeting. In the region where I'm in at the moment, there are dozens of different networking meetings. And in fact, at the time of making this video, one of the best is the Four Networking Organization. UK-wide, it has tens of thousands of members and provides attendees with an opportunity to go to a different networking meeting in their region almost every morning if they wish. So the true secret to attracting new business is not to go to a networking meeting in the hope of collecting business cards and then calling them to try and sell your products and services. That's not how networking works. Networking is all about getting to know the people at the networking meetings you attend, and for them to get to know more about you and your business, and then they'll tell others about you. It's all about mutual cooperation. If you help them spread the word about their business, you can be sure that they'll do the same for you. And isn't that what business networking is all about? The best networking meetings are ones where you get to mingle with members rather than become sat next to one person for a whole meeting. Networking meetings with a wide geographical spread are also well worth considering, because you can usually attend meetings in other regions when you're traveling around. Conferences and seminars are another opportunity to network, but the main problem here is that you can frequently end up sat between two people, either in the talks or at lunch, with little opportunity to meet a lot of people. Exhibitions and demonstrations are good places to meet people too. I often say to people that if they have absolutely nothing better to do today, go and find somewhere that's free to mingle with other people. There might be a free cat grooming exhibition, for example. You go along, even if you don't own a cat or know anything about cats, and end up talking to a lady about grooming cats, who happens to have a father who owns a large company near you, who could just happen to need your products and services. You see, you never know where your next customer is coming from. So you need to widen your horizons and know that one person leads to another, which leads to another. Another way to network in business is to join online business networking groups. Often these are spread to all corners of the globe, which might be important for you if you have a product or service that you can sell worldwide. You have to be a little bit cautious, however, because sometimes fraudsters and tricksters join these networks in disguise so that they can trick you out of your hard-earned money, or worse still, steal your identity. The best way to find a networking group is to simply type your location into Google and the words networking meeting and see what comes up. You can also try your local Chamber of Commerce, who will usually have a list of networking opportunities in your area. You might consider trying prestigious clubs like Lions or Rotary too, although often you need to know someone on the inside who can nominate you as a member. You just can't walk into Rotary, you need to be invited. To network effectively and open up a wide potential customer base, you need to be a good listener and treat everyone with respect and as an equal. You have to have stacks of empathy for the other person and market their businesses without expecting them to do likewise. You need to be friendly and approachable and show a genuine interest in other people and their businesses, not just your business. It's absolutely essential that you make an effort to make conversation with people. And if you say you'll ring somebody later that day, make sure you do. You have to always be ready to hand out business cards and marketing literature, but never be too pushy when you do it. Many networking meetings nowadays allow you to leave your marketing materials on a side table for people to pick up, rather than have everyone throwing leaflets at each other. You have to experiment with your networking techniques. You have to be outgoing and prepared to start up a conversation with people. Always have one or two topical items up your sleeve to open a conversation with, or for those occasions when conversations tend to get strained or go dry. When talking, be aware of how much talking you do. If it's just you and another person, you should not talk more than 50% of the time, and if there's three of you, then 30%, and if four, 25%, etc. Give others the opportunity to talk, and remember that people love it when you talk about them and their issue rather than yours. If you do these things, then I absolutely guarantee that the membership network that you join will open up a bit like a lotus flower and lead to more contacts than you could ever dream of. No matter which network organization you attend, you should be able to get the fees back fairly quickly through the extra customers that you'll eventually attract. And by the way, Don't ever believe anyone who tells you that a certain networking group is hopeless. It might be them that's hopeless at networking, not the meeting. If there are people present at a networking meeting, no matter who or what the group is all about, then there are opportunities for you. It's up to you to spot them and work at making friendships. Business networking is an art which has to be worked at and practiced constantly. Networking takes effort, energy, lots of time and lots of work, lots of commitment and a certain amount of courage, but it can pay off with huge rewards if you're prepared to make a few sacrifices. Thank you for watching. I trust you found the information in this video helpful.